but it's all good.
Make your way.
With these levels, it's inevitable. Like, I'm not gonna get Deathless on my first try. There's no way in hell. I certainly won't get it in Shizor's. I'm calling it right now because I have no idea how I'm gonna do the second half of that level without dying. Gonna be a real slap in the balls. Oh, come on. Nice. You'll have to let me know how it performs. Only handheld I need to really buy is a new DS, because my current one kind of sucks. It's R button, or it's L button's kind of fucked up. We can't be having that on these parts, son. I need that L button for Mario Kart. Just a reminder, everybody, that Mario Kart DS is my favorite Mario Kart game, and it is also the best one, and this is not up for debate. Well, it might be. It's up to debate, depending on what your answer is. If you tell me that 64 is better, then you can go fuck yourself, to be honest. I thought about a 3DS as well, just because I don't have one. And there's a couple of 3DS games I want to play. Problem is that I want a really specific 3DS. I want one of the purple ones, because why not? It's my favorite color, so. And I almost bought one when I first moved to, moved out here for my college. I bought one just because I had some extra money, and in retrospect, I'm glad I didn't. Not because I, you know, thought it was a bad investment, but just because it would have cost me a lot of money. And I didn't have a ton of it going into school. The original- no the fuck it isn't, get out of here. The original Super Mario Kart. Imagine just objectively being wrong, that's crazy. Look, I'm gonna be honest. I don't think 64 is the worst Mario Kart game, but it's definitely not even remotely close to the best. The best controls, this motherfucker's literally on drugs. Holy shit. Imagine saying it has the best controls when Double Dash exists. Or Mario Kart 8 for that matter. Holy shit, I'm about to throw hands. Don't be mad, I suck at it. Dude, I'm fine at the game. It doesn't change the fact that it's trash. The only game better than... or the only game that might have had worse controls than 64 was... well, no. I don't know, it's weird. I definitely'd say the hardest one to control is definitely the Super Nintendo one, but I mean, it was the first of its kind. I'll give it the benefit of the doubt. And it still works well enough for being a Super Nintendo game. On top of that, 64's tracks are not even that good. It has one of the worst versions of Rainbow Road.
You found the boost field of the activator.
Anyone who tells me that Rainbow Road for the 64 is literally wearing rose-tinted glasses. That track is fucking abysmal compared to the other ones. It's way too long, and it's really boring. I never fall off Rainbow Road. It's just like every other version of Rainbow Road is just better than 64's. It's also funny how kids who literally are only good at 64 will only say that 64 is the one that's the best. This is something that happens every time. Alright, where am I at challenge point-wise? Okay, so I'm doing this right. Now here comes the worst part of this level. I don't got a baby mom who buys consoles, I buy that shit myself. I'm a grown-ass adult. Alright, this part's- oh god, oh sh- actually it didn't do as much damage as I thought it would. Holy fuck. This is just gonna be a game of... hopefully guessing right. It sucks because I really can't afford to go up for air. Alright, let's fight. Don't even need to. That was not as bad as I thought it was going to be. Goku is the best racer in Mario 64. You know what? I'll give him that. That's correct. Bitch, I don't got big boy money. I got money and that's it. Even Barney is better than him. Well, if we consult the official tier list, that might be correct, actually. Alright, that was not as bad as I thought it would be. I think I died once.